Hi everyone, November 10, 2018. I'm going to start this video with this woman talking about her experience in a flash flood in Hawaii. But this video is primarily on the fires and what our community is doing about it. Well, let's listen to her.
To get through, because the cars were coming this way, so I was like, oh, no big deal. And I've gotten through the rivers before, so I was like, I can make it this time. But then, car in front of me got stuck, and then another car got stuck, so I was like, crap, like, I'm not going to make it. And the water started coming up to the windshield, and the car started stiffening up, and my brakes didn't work, steering wheel didn't work, and the car just eventually gave out. So I was just floating in the water, and at one point, like, I started floating backwards, and I got stuck with a log behind the wheel, and then the fire department came, and that was it.
So how did they get you out?
Eventually, well, they pushed me out, and eventually the water started going down a little bit, but yeah.
So up to your window.
Mm-hmm.
And how fast did that?
It was going pretty quickly. I rolled down my window to see if I could get out and maybe push the car myself, but it was going way too fast for me to even get out.
So it was five cars total?
Not exactly sure. I know there was one in front of me, and then there was one coming behind me, but it backed out, and then this car, and I think there was one more, but I'm not positive on that.
So the people who pushed you out is the people in the neighborhood?
No, it was the fire department.
Okay.
All right. I want you to... I've tried very hard to present on my channel a big picture view of what is taking place in the world. And just in 2018, and I have not captured it all, but I have playlists of flooding that has taken place around the world. I have missed an awful lot of it, but look at the number of videos. Just on my playlist alone, my channel alone, and then there are many other channels that are posting videos on flash flooding events that are taking place around the world. I got a comment from a subscriber who talked of her sister living in Kuwait. This comment just came today. Her sister lives in Kuwait, and she was talking about the massive flash flooding taking place in Kuwait. So I checked it out. There are so many areas of the world that are getting destroyed. The camels, this was, I don't know, 2 weeks ago, camels, and I can't even remember what country it was in. These camels died in a flash flood. Venice, France, flooding a couple of weeks ago. Spain, flooding. This is going on all over the world. Kuwait, floods. Jordan, floods. Kuwait had their floods 9/11. Jordan, massive flooding, killing people, destroying people's homes, destroying the infrastructure of countries. Trinidad. Have we even spoken about what's going on in Trinidad? To feel
not good. Water comes up, we could move nothing. I lost everything. I didn't get to take a step in just a few feet. Oh, God. I never see anything like this. Oh, God.
Let me be.
In the arms of
some peace tonight.
Okay. Yeah, it's... I can't tell you if you've not been, you know, and many people don't have the time, which I fully understand. And because I don't work, I have had the time, and I can't stand that I am facing so many limitations now that I can't do what I used to be able to do. We are seeing this war, this weather being used as a weapon, fires being used as a weapon all over the world. And it is overwhelming. We've got flash flooding, extreme flash flooding in desert areas. Saudi Arabia. Unfortunately, we have an awful lot of people who just are incapable of critical thinking. They allow their government officials, mainstream media, to do their thinking for them. So what do they think? They think, oh, well, it's climate change. Well, it's not climate change. It is not climate change. Now, I just created another playlist. U.S. flooding. Why? Because I'm an American, and most of my subscribers are Americans. And I can't do anything about what's happening in Saudi Arabia, Jordan, Kuwait, Trinidad. The only place that I can do anything is in my own community. Communities really need to come together to help one another now. The quote-unquote truth community needs to step up to the plate. You know, I went and I checked out many channels, the big channels, those with, oh God, so many subscribers, just to see if they were posting on the fires. And they're not. They're not. Okay, I don't get what's happening, how we could be having hell brought upon California again, and hardly anybody is posting on what is taking place there. But I want you to see what has been taking place just this year, 2018. And I'm only one person, so I have not been able to capture all of the flooding that has occurred right here in the United States. These are the videos all over our country, all over. And I included the videos that there are people who are just waking up and they're asking, why is this occurring? Why is this occurring? Okay, you're going to have to do some research, and you can check out people's channels. Go to their channel page and look to see if they have playlists. Go through their videos to understand what's happening. FEMA buying out flooded homes. No rebuilding. Create the green space in Agenda 2030, 50 mega regions. I have posted many videos on connecting the dots, the weather events, depopulation, employment opportunities, oh, that just so happened to be in the mega regions. They want people out of specific areas of this country. They are reshaping our country to force people into particular mega regions So they're living in these stack and packs, these little tiny apartments. People will no longer be able to travel. You won't be using your cars. You'll be able to walk in your mega region. You will have 24/7 surveillance. Why? Because this is the way that they will be able to have complete and utter control over your life, your children's life, everybody's life within the mega regions. Everything is connected. Everything. So you can watch these videos, but you have to understand, we have just in this past year seen such massive destruction all over the country. The Upper Peninsula, Michigan, was so destroyed. Areas, the infrastructure, bridges, roads, train tracks, they are destroying it all. Who's they? Well, deep state, the military-industrial complex, and the very evil, sick, twisted, everything is an understatement when you're talking about this elite. I can't think of any other word but scum that happen to be in positions of power, leading us to just walk right on over the edge. So the flash flooding that has been occurring all over the country has been enormous. And do you know how many Americans are suffering? They're still suffering the effects of these faux hurricanes. And I say faux hurricanes because there's an awful lot of evidence that proves that these were not hurricanes, but flash flooding, perhaps the opening of dams to create more flash flooding. It's really heartbreaking when you see the amount. Now, some of these videos that I made are compilations, and I can't do it anymore. But you need to understand that as you go about your life, if you still have not suffered the consequences of these events, it's coming to you. But the only way that we can survive, the only way that we can survive is if we help one another. So we've got to start thinking outside the box and figure out how can we help one another. And we can't keep donating to places like Red Cross and Google because the money is not reaching the American people. FEMA is not helping the American people. They are not getting the help that they need. So we can't let one another go down. We have to figure out ways to help one another. And the help needs to come from the community primarily. Those in the areas where people are having their lives destroyed, their homes destroyed. So let's get to the fires. And yes, I'm sorry that it's long, but I did want to, in this video, show you. We now, as I speak, have millions of Americans struggling. Where do they go? Who is helping? You know, I got a comment from, and I can't believe I had that open. I wanted to read the comment to you. And mysteriously vanished. So I started looking for it. It was taking me too long, but it was underneath a video that I posted yesterday, but I posted many on the California fires. And she spoke of working in Kohl's in Chico, California, which is right next to Paradise, and all of these people from Paradise. Paradise is gone. 6,700 homes burned to the ground, businesses burned to the ground. Paradise, the entire town was taken out in 24 hours. Well, you better believe that directed energy weapons were used, that this was deliberate, because this is not how forest fires work. They do not take out 6,700 homes and then add on to that the businesses and the churches and leave the trees intact. Okay, so we know that we are at war, but the comment writing about all of these people from Paradise, Kohl's gave them 30% off, those who had lost everything. Well, you know what? 30% off, nice gesture, but Kohl's, you've got a tremendous amount of money, and these people lost everything. I'm sorry, 30% off is not enough. Americans, we've got to come out of our selfishness and greed and do things so differently now. She was talking about how heartbreaking it was to see all of these people who have lost everything. I want to point out Mike Morales's videos to you. And he has been, and this is a repost of his video. I'm quite sure that is Mike Morales, right?
As you see it.
Yes.
Right there too. As you can see, something is accelerating the fire, blowing it with wind, and also creating a fire. Now, there looks to me like they're burning it, okay, with this liquid plasma or whatever the hell they use to shoot out of these tubes. It's absolute fire, and it's burning it. So they're creating the fire as they go along. And watch how the aerial creates and moves the fire as it turns. It's absolutely 100% orchestrated with machines. There's no other way to say it. Okay, it's not about people starting fires and leaving cigarettes and campfires and having cars spark. It's not about that. It's about who's involved in it and what the hell they're using. Look at this. Okay, do you see this damn thing goes all the way up to here? All right, then you have one coming out of it and then one coming out of here. And that's the one that's spraying the look, you can see it coming out right there. Okay. It's spraying it out.
But he also makes note of this line right here that you see. Now, we all need to make sure that our minds are not closed, that we have open minds so that when we see videos and we hear what people are saying, like some people say ships and machines and all of that, have an open mind. The technology that we know of is not the only thing out there that is creating the destruction that we are seeing. So I just want to, you know, say that while we know that these are being set deliberately, we know an awful lot now about directed energy weapons, but there's so much that we don't know. And thank God for people like Mike Morales who point out other things that we don't know. But I get comments from people saying, we need the evidence. We have so much, we have mountains of evidence already. We don't need any more, though the more we get, thank God. But I'm saying throughout the years, we have had so much evidence that we are being taken down rapidly. And We don't know, we don't need to know precisely who is involved. What we need are Americans to open their minds, to begin to critically think, to do the research, and to stop leaving. Well, I have been getting a lot of comments from people that I just delete. Conspiracy theorists, nut job, crazy. But we have Americans in our own lives doing exactly the same thing, and somehow they've got to grow up because this behavior is so immature. We need Americans to be united, to stand together, to put away their petty differences. And those differences, when they're spoken, they go for one another's jugular. This is insane. You know, I look at the big channels and they're posting on the election still, politics, the election. And this is a sideshow. It's a distraction. We have a thoroughly corrupt system, and it's not going to just be okay when you have the Democrats taking the House. Well, we know that's not going to happen. But even if the Republicans took the House, it doesn't matter. The most important thing is this war that we are in and the weapons that they are using to kill your fellow Americans, to kill animals, to kill life, to destroy people's homes. And we've got millions and millions, and I've been saying all year, certainly, more and more Americans go down, more and more go down every single day. But we're going to focus on that friggin' election as if it's going to do anything. All right. So, Mike Morales, you can check out his videos. There were other videos that he has posted just in the last couple of days on these fires that need to be seen. Like, where is it? Blast wave site of fires. Something happened right here, and it is like a blast wave. Okay. Something ignites right here, and it's being pushed. That's amazing. It's being pushed. Is igniting right here. And guess what? That's the area where the fires are. I want to show you another video that he has posted.
Warfare. We got some crazy fires going on over on the West Coast we're going to get into. And it starts dropping back down, and then it's got its own signature of smoke. So it goes in two different ways. That is there. This, look how you can see the shadow of whatever this is shooting way up off the ground. It's real white. All the rest of the smoke is black. And just look at that. It just shoots up. That is something.
Okay.
And look, it's...
Thank you, Mike, for doing this work. Campfire Paradise Lost. All right. I will link below to everything, but this is the consequence. This is the consequence.
Hi, baby!
Thank you. the wildlife that has survived without their family, mothers, baby deer walking on the streets, horses. Yeah, and a lot of people then, well, not a lot of people, but some people leave comments saying, I can't believe that you showed that. That's so heartbreaking. And you should have warned me before seeing that. Not particularly on those videos, but I do get, you know, when on my channel, I show the horror. Well, you need to see the horror. You need to understand how many people, how many horses and deer and all of our, you know, fabulous beings, how they are suffering the consequences of this. And it is our job to protect them. This is, I don't even know where this is. California roads after fire. This is what we are repeatedly living now. And as California, more and more of it gets destroyed. Then you have people leaving comments. Good. Still I get the comments. Commie state, take it out. Hope everybody dies. We have such vicious people in this country. So, Malibu apocalypse, stars flee, and look at this picture. So, the stars flee. The A-list of people. They're on the A-list because they're stars. There is no life on this planet that is more valuable than any other life. But that's what's happened to Americans. We believe that if somebody's famous and rich, they're more valuable than anybody else. Well, I will tell you that these people shouldn't get any attention because they are absolutely fine. Lady Gaga, the Kardashians, Caitlyn Jenner, all of these people, do you think that they don't have the means? Will Smith, they don't have the means? They have multiple homes. They have money up the wazoo. And I can't stand that people will go to these news stories because it's about the celebrities and the bachelor house. Oh my God, that burned down. But what about all of the people who don't get any attention? They suffer. The people that are given attention, they don't suffer. They don't suffer. But no, we're going to listen to Caitlyn Jenner talk about her mansion in Malibu Hills. I am so sick of this celebrity, this, you know, every ordinary Americans. Going, oh my God, there's somebody famous. Aren't they wonderful? Oh, how heartbreaking. They lost their home. Really? Really? Give me a friggin' break. The reason why these people get the attention is because so many Americans, they just love it. They want to know about these famous people's lives, and oh, they're just so upset that they've lost their homes. What about the deer? What about the horses? What about all of the people who have lost their homes that can't afford to recover? Do you care about them? And I'm not talking to you guys. But now Trump threatens to withhold California fire aid, citing state's gross mismanagement of forests. All right, so what's going to happen? More people get hurt. Do you understand? Government has not worked for us. Government does not work for us. Government has failed us repeatedly. It continues to fail us. And that's why we've got to somehow come together and help one another. Malibu. Hundreds of thousands of people have been evacuated. Not a single resident of Paradise, California can be seen anywhere in town. In a single day, the Sierra Nevada foothill town of 27,000 was largely incinerated by flames that moved so fast there was nothing firefighters could do. Only a day after the campfire began, the blaze had destroyed more than 6,700 structures, almost all of them homes, making it California's most destructive wildfire since record keeping began, and that doesn't beg questions. In adult American minds, how did that happen in one day? It happened because they are using this as a weapon. They have directed energy weapons that can take out entire towns in 24 hours, giving no one time to collect what they desperately need. Many people couldn't escape the fire. They found dead as skeletons. Their skin, everything incinerated, gone. Just skeletons sitting in cars. Campfire grows to 100,000 acres now. All right, well, what do we got? Red flag warning. Almost all of California is under a red flag warning. A graphic for Sunday's expected gusts. So we're going to see more high winds. And I'll just give you some of the numbers. Three major fires, the Camp Fire, Woolsey Fire, the Hill Fire. Camp Fire, Butte County, 90,000 acres. No, it's 100,000 now. 5% contained. I think it might be 20% contained now. But this is an article that was posted earlier this morning. 35 people reported missing. Only 35? Really? 1,385 people in shelters, and 52,000 have been evacuated just from this area. Where are they? The woman who left that comment, who worked at Kohl's, talked of people having 25 people from Paradise in their homes. 25. So 52,000 evacuated and only 1,385 in shelters. The shelters are overwhelmed. They can't take any more people. Shelters mostly are in Chico. Where have these people gone? Over and over again, we face these events. We don't know where the people go. Woolsey Fire, Ventura County, 200,000 residents under mandatory evacuation, 35,000 acres burned, and it's 0% contained. Still haven't heard anything from Jane Tandy. Hill Fire, Ventura County, 4,500 acres burned, 15% contained. Firefighters are making good progress on that one. This is what we're living. Somewhere in the country, every single day, Americans are being taken out. Now, who's posting on this? Well, we have a Frederick Pinard.
Various parts of California are under siege right now. A lot of the property is not being sold back to the people or not being given back to the people. Even if they own it, California legislature is not letting them rebuild. They're not letting them rebuild. They're making it so tough on them to rebuild that people just give up, move out of the area, even if they had insurance. What was it in Sonoma and Napa Valley or Napa last year? They made it so difficult for the people to come back in and rebuild their houses. A lot of people just gave up. I haven't seen a lot of people in the Truth Movement talking about that lately. But
having gone through so many channels looking to see what they're posting on and seeing that a whole lot of people, even those in California, they're posting on the election and all this other stuff, but right in the area close to where they live, they're not posting on these fires. And I find that really, well, I don't understand that. So we have to figure out a way to help one another, because Americans are just, you know, most of them are our enemy. They're our enemy because they refuse to even engage in conversation about what really is taking place in this country and weather being used as a weapon, fire being used as a weapon to take out many people. We are at war. Oh, if the bombs were dropping, they would understand we are at war. But no, they're going to call us crazy because they're using weapons that are unconventional in this war. So what are we left with? We're left with an awful lot of Americans who are suffering, and we need to figure out how to lift them up, help them. Anybody have an idea? Please post a comment on that idea. But something's got to be done differently. We have to all now think outside the box in terms of what we can do to help people. How can we help people? And please, all of you who are still comfortable, I hope that every single day that you work through any complacency that you may have, that you prepare for the time when you get hit. Because I have, just on my channel alone, I've had so many subscribers in my 6 years of posting. They were comfortable, and then they weren't. And you know what? That's something that you want to really avoid. You want to make sure that your friends and your family are going to be there for you when you need it. And I do think that everybody should be having discussions with their friends, with their family, in terms of anything happening in your community and how you're going to deal with it. Make sure that you have people in your life that you can trust, that you know that you can trust. Because when the shit hits the fan, well, I've experienced it, and so have so many other people experienced it. Those they thought they could trust were not there for them. So we're living a time of Americans showing their true colors. And they're not very nice colors. So if we don't change for one another and really support and help one another, we're dead. All links are below.